Storj Labs is building an open, decentralized future with innovative technologies to make data storage extremely private, secure, reliable, and affordable. We're happy to be participating in the Internet Archive's dWeb Meetup focused on decentralized cloud storage. Our goal is to build the world's largest storage service that delivers on that vision without ever building a single data center. While the commercial launch of the Tardigrade platform was in 2020, the project has been evolving to solve the complex challenge of decentralized cloud storage since 2014, when our founder, Sean Wilkinson, came up with the idea for Storj Labs and created the first prototype at the Texas Bitcoin Hackathon. We launched our previous network in 2017 and achieved 100 plus petabytes of data stored across more than 100,000 storage nodes. Shortly after that, Ben Golub, formerly the CEO and co-founder at Docker, joined our team as executive chairman and interim CEO. In 2018, we took the lessons learned from our previous network to build a decentralized cloud storage service that could compete with Amazon Web Services and all the other major cloud storage providers. Our service is called Tardigrade, and it's now fully operational with enterprise-grade SLAs. The storage leadership team includes individuals with a unique mix of experience in storage, distributed systems, token ecosystems, open source, startups, and established companies. Storj is one of the longest-standing decentralized projects and is recognized as a leader in the field of token governance. Our compliance-first approach led to the early establishment of key policies and practices to build a culture of solid governance and corporate citizenship. With almost 50 team members in 14 different countries, we've not only built an incredible platform, but a great company as well that's as distributed as the platform we serve. Storj Labs operates a platform that provides secure, affordable distributed cloud storage. There are three parts to the network: a shared supply of storage capacity, apps that provide demand for that cloud storage capacity, and the platform that connects the supply and demand. We make open source software that anyone can run. Individuals with a network-attached storage device, or NAS, those with desktop computers that are always on, businesses, or even data centers, that allows these users, who are called storage node operators, to share unused disk drive space and bandwidth with the network. The software aggregates all of that storage capacity and bandwidth to create an extremely secure, private, and durable cloud storage platform for developers. Storj Labs sells storage and bandwidth with an enterprise-grade 99.95% availability and 99s of durability under the Tardigrade brand. When developers store data on the platform, their files are end-to-end encrypted from the client side, by default, and then split into 80 erasure-coded pieces before distribution across our network of connected storage nodes. The client-side managed end-to-end encryption combined with our edge-based access management capabilities provide easy-to-use tools for building applications that are more private, more secure, and less susceptible to a range of common attack vectors. This is a simplified overview of how the Tardigrade service works. When files are uploaded, they're first encrypted and split into 80 pieces. Of those 80 pieces, any 29 can be used to reconstitute the file. Each of the 80 pieces is stored on different statistically uncorrelated storage nodes with different operators, different power supplies, different networks, different geographies, etc., yielding tremendous security, performance, and durability advantages. Our decentralized architecture offers improved out-of-the-box security and privacy for our clients. It also enables comparable performance and reliability compared to centralized cloud storage providers. Developers have the option to pay either with credit cards or storage tokens built on the Ethereum platform. Meanwhile, storage node operators earn storage tokens for the storage space and bandwidth used by these developers in their applications. Now I'd like to give a short demonstration on just how easy it is to upload data to the Tardigrade platform. One of the things that will become immediately clear is that the Tardigrade platform is a tool for developers to use as a storage layer for applications. We're not a decentralized alternative to Dropbox. We're an alternative to Amazon's S3 Cloud Object Storage, something on which an application like Dropbox might be built. What I'm going to demonstrate is logging into a satellite account, getting an API key, then using our command line interface to create a bucket, upload a file to that bucket, list the contents of the bucket, download the file, and then finally delete the file. In this example, I'm going to be uploading this delicious slice of cheesecake that's pictured in the photo, then downloading and deleting it. I'm going to log into an account on my satellite. If you want to try this at home, you can register online and set up your own account. A satellite is one of the primary components of the storage network and has four main responsibilities: developer account registration and management, API credential and access management, billing and payment, and finally, audit and repair. Any user can run their own satellite, but we expect many users to elect to avoid the operational complexity and create an account on another satellite, hosted by a trusted third party such as Storj Labs, a friend, community group, or workplace. The majority of users select their satellite based on geographic proximity. Once you're logged in, you'll see your dashboard and billing information, as well as your projects. I'm logged in to the US Central satellite. Now I need to create an API key. I'm going to navigate to my Instagram Crackers project, my dessert photo sharing app. I'm going to click on API keys in the sidebar, and next I create new API key to start the process. I'm going to name my API key Cakes, then click Next to reveal my secret API key. I'll just copy and save this API key to my clipboard. For security reasons, an API key is only displayed once. I'm not going to be able to display it again. At this point, we're done with the web interface and can switch to the command line interface. We offer developers a range of options to develop applications, including the CLI, an S3 compatible gateway, and a developer library with bindings for a number of popular languages. We've also got integrations with a number of useful open source tools, including Rclone and Rustric. For this simple example, though, we'll use the CLI. The Uplink CLI is an application that allows you to access object storage from the command line. You can use this tool to upload and manage objects in buckets, as well as to securely share access to objects stored on the platform. The Uplink binary is available for download from the documentation. I'm using a Mac, but we also have versions for Windows and Linux available. I've downloaded the Uplink binary and extracted it to a folder called Storage Uplink on my laptop. In the directory, you'll see that I've also got the Uplink binary, the cheesecake photo, and an empty folder for downloads. Now let's set up the Uplink CLI. In a terminal window, I'm going to run the Uplink setup command. The first thing I'm prompted to do is choose a satellite. I'll choose the same satellite where I set up my API key and copy to my workspace to the left. Next, I'll choose an access name. And in this case, I'll press Enter for the default. An access is an easy-to-use feature for file sharing. It lets you create an access credential on the client side that can be shared with another Uplink client to gain access to an object or path. The access includes both an API key scoped to authorize access only to the assets you want to share, plus an encryption key that's also scoped to decrypt only the assets you want to share. I'm not showcasing the file sharing in this demo, but be sure to check out our documentation. Now, take the API key that you created and saved from the previous step and enter that. And finally, it's going to ask for an encryption passphrase. Create and confirm an encryption passphrase, which is used to encrypt your files and metadata associated with your files before they're uploaded. The client-side managed end-to-end encryption provides security and privacy required for distributed and decentralized systems, so neither the satellite nor the storage nodes ever have access to your encryption keys or in any way the data that you uploaded to the platform. That means that you're responsible for your encryption key, and if you lose it, you've lost the ability to decrypt and recover your data. Now you've completed the setup for the Uplink CLI, now I'll create a bucket. The convention we'll follow is to use the Uplink executable plus standard commands. All the commands and options are documented at documentation.tardigrade.io, so you can check it out later. Let's create a bucket to store photos of cake for our food app. The command for creating a bucket is mb. With that simple command, we've just created a bucket called cakes. Next, I'll upload a file. To upload our file, let's use the copy command, cp. And you can see that I'm specifying cakes as the path. The copy command copies a file from outside the storage bucket to inside or vice versa. With that one command, that cheesecake photo was encrypted client-side with AES 256 GCM encryption, then erasure-coded and split into 80 pieces. Those 80 pieces were uploaded peer-to-peer to 80 different statistically uncorrelated storage nodes. Now that we've uploaded the file to the bucket, we can list the contents of the bucket to see the newly uploaded file. To view the cheesecake photo in our bucket, we'll use the list command. The list command is simply ls. We'll use it to look inside cakes and see that the cheesecake.jpg is in our cakes bucket. Uploading and listing objects is great, but we also need to get our data back again. To download our cheesecake photo, let's use the copy command again. After I run the command, you can see the cheesecake file is now in my downloads folder. This time, with just the cp command, 29 pieces of the 80 total pieces on the network were downloaded from the 29 fastest storage nodes, re-encoded using Reed-Solomon erasure coding, and decrypted client-side using my encryption passphrase. Now let's say that for some unknown reason, we don't want cheesecake anymore. We delete the photo with the following command, rm. This removes the specified file from the bucket, deleting all the metadata from the satellite and the 80 pieces from the 80 different storage nodes. This is just a quick demo to give you a sense of how the platform works. There's a lot more to it and some amazing security and privacy capabilities for you to discover when you unlock the power of decentralized cloud storage. During a period where trust in data is low, the preservation of data and cryptographic proof of its integrity is more important than ever. Part of our mission is to enable a new standard for cloud object storage, one that is more resilient and purpose-built for zero-trust environments. Due to its unique security model, we believe that decentralized cloud storage is especially well-suited for the preservation and resilience of important public data. One initiative we have underway today is offering free storage to scientific research and other initiatives related to solving challenges arising from the COVID-19 pandemic. With so much at stake, we're contributing free space to enable and preserve data related to COVID-19. Please join us at the dWeb Meetup to learn more about the project, the technology, and our experience building and operating an enterprise-grade distributed and decentralized cloud storage platform. Hope to see you there.